Sorry, but the record has stopped and I have not noticed. And then I record the part, the missing part between the previous and the next record. Well, we have a matrix A. Matrix A 4, negative 8, 10, negative 2, 2, negative 4, 4, negative 6. This is the matrix A. The matrix C of the basic change is the matrix C is 1, 1, 1, 1, 2, negative 1, 0, 1, negative 1. Well, we have to compute in order to perform in order to obtain the matrix A prime equal C to negative 1, A, C. In this case, we have only one basis change because the linear application L to which the matrix A is associated is an endomorphism. A is associated to the abstract linear application L from R3 into R3, and then we have at the beginning the same canonical basis in the first and in the second vector space. At the beginning we have the canonical basis, then we pass to the vectors, to the basis, the basis B1. From the basis B we pass to the base B prime equal B1, B2, B3, which are the eigenvectors, three eigenvectors of the matrix A. The first eigenvector is this one. The second eigenvector is the second column. The third eigenvector is the third column. Since the initial basis, the first basis, is canonical, the canonical basis, in this case, the coefficient to be given to the canonical basis, to the canonical vectors of the first basis, to obtain the new vectors, the new basis vectors, which are the eigenvectors, are exactly the components of the eigenvectors themselves, and then the column are the eigenvectors themselves. Well, now we have to perform matrix form. We have to write first C plus C, the inverse C. How can we get the matrix, the inverse matrix of the matrix C? C to minus 1, we have to compute the determinant of C. Determinant of C equal. We use the first column because we have 1, 0. And then I take this element 1 times its times the determinant of its complemental minor. Minus 1 times the determinant of its complemental minor. Now we have the complemental minor of one of this one here is negative 2 plus 1 is negative 1. The complemental minor of this element is negative 1 minus 1 negative 2 equal 2 positive 2 minus 1 1. The matrix C of the basis change and determinant 1. Now we compute the adjoint matrix. Adjoint e a joint matrix denoted by tilde C. Tilde C is the matrix whose elements are the determinants of all the determinant of the complemental minor of all elements of C. The complemental minor, the adjoint matrix, the adjoint matrix denoted by tilde C of the matrix C is the matrix whose elements are all the determinant of all elements of C. Determinants of the complemental minor of the elements of C multiplied by minus 1 to i + j. Determinant of a complemental minor times this factor, where I and J are the row and the column of the element of which we are computing the determinant of. Okay, now, the determinant of this element is negative 2 plus 1 is negative 1 times positive 1, because this is row 1, column 1, and then the sum is even number, positive. Now, the determinant of the complemental minor of this element is negative 1 minus 0 is negative 1, but we have to change the sign, 1. The determinant of the complemental minor of this element is 1 minus 0, 1, without changes of the sign, 1. Now, the determinant of the complemental minor of this element is negative 1 minus 1 is negative 2. But times negative 1 minus 1 is negative 2, positive 2. This element has the complemental minor at the angles, and then the determinant is -1 minus 0, -1, unchanged. This element has the complemental minor. 1 minus 0, the determinant of the complemental minor is 1 minus 0. 1, but we have to change the sign, negative 1. The complemental minor of 0 is this one, whose determinant is negative 1 minus 2, negative 3, unchanged. Negative 3. This element 1 is complemental minor, this one whose determinant is -1 minus 1 is -2, with the change of the sign is 2. The complemental minor of this element is this one whose determinant is 2 minus 1, 1, unchanged. This is the inverse, the adjoint matrix. Adjoint matrix tilde C of C. Now, the inverse matrix is 1 over the determinant of C, 1 over 1, times the transpose matrix of this adjoint matrix. The rows must be written in columns. -1, 1, 1. The second row becomes the second column. 2, -1, -1. The third row becomes the third column. -3, 2, 1. Well, now we compute A prime equal inverse C. One over one is one. Negative one, two, negative three. One, negative one, two. One, negative one, one. Times. Ma this is C inverse C. Times A. Four, negative eight, ten. Negative two, negative two, two. Third row, negative four. Four, negative six. Times C. Inverse C. Times A, times C. Inverse C, times A, times C. C is this matrix. One, one, one. 1, 2, negative 1. 0, 1, negative 1. Equal. This is the matrix C. Now, the matrix product is not commutative, but at least associative. We can begin either by multiplying this pair of matrix. The first two matrices. By leaving the result on the left with respect to the third matrix. Or we can begin by multiplying the second and third matrix and leaving the result on the right with respect to this matrix. It is the same because the product, the matrix product, is associated. Let's begin with this product, the first matrix equal. First row times first column, negative four, negative four. Minus four is negative four, minus four is negative eight plus 12 is positive four. First row times second column, a positive eight, minus four is four, four. Minus 12 is negative 8. First row times third column, negative 10 plus 2, negative 10 plus 4 is negative 6. Negative 6 plus 18 is positive 12. Second row times third column, 4 plus 2 is 6. 6 minus 8 is negative 2. Second row times second column. Negative 8 plus 2, negative 8 plus 2 is negative 6. Negative 6 plus 8 is 2. Second row times third column. 10. Minus 2 is 8. 8 minus 12 is negative 4. Third row times first column. 4 plus 2 is 4. Plus 2 is 6. 6 minus 4 is 2. Third row times second column is negative 8 plus 2 is negative 6. Negative 6 plus 4 is negative 2. Third row times third column. 10 minus 2 is 8. 8 minus 6. 10 minus 2 is 8. Minus 6 is 2. This is the product of the first two matrices. This matrix is the product of the first two matrices. Now, this matrix must stay on the left with respect to the third matrix. 1, 1, 1, 2, -1, 0, 1, -1. Equal, now the calculation, this last matrix product continues in the next record. Thank you, and sorry for the missing part of the previous record. I can repeat, the first law is -4 - -4 - -8 + 12 = 4. First row, second column. +8 - -4 = 4. -8 - -4 = 4. 4 - 12 = -8. With the first row, third column. -10 + 4 - -6 - 18 = 12. The second row, 4 + 2 = 6 - 8 - 2. Second row, second column, -8 + 2 = -6 - 8 = 2. Second row, third column, 10 - -2 = 8 - -12 = -4. The third row gives third column times first column. 4 + 2 = 6 - 4 = 2. Third row, second column, -8 + 2 = -6 - 6 + 4 = -2. Third row, third column, 10 - 2 = 8 - 8 - 6 = 2. Positive 2. And now we leave this matrix on the left. We copy the third matrix here, and we perform the last multiplication. The third matrix must stay on the right. The last multiplication that continues in the next record. Sorry, thank you, and sorry for the missing record. I stop this record.